Jesus the Nagaran. He's in one of his songs, his favorite song about his ministry. He went through a lot of suffering and pain. His own daughter he lost. And his own son Paul was not willing to move with the father in the beginning. So he himself could not get enough money to take care of the family. He wanted to go and die, keep his head on the railway track. That was D.J. Sthanaran's life story. And then he says, he sings the song. Of course, he composed in Tamil, then he composed it in, translated into various languages. Jesus calls us on. Jesus calls us on. Stretching out his arms to heal all our wounds. Jesus calls us on. Yes, this little light God has given to us. That's why in Matthew's Gospel, chapter 5, the Lord said, don't keep the light that God has given to you under the cot. No, keep alive that light God has given to you, because your journey is too long. The Lord spoke in the book of 1 Kings chapter 19. God said to the servant of him, Elijah, who wanted to die. He lost all the hope because he trusted in people. When God was with him, when he was aware that my God is with me, he prepared the fire, he prepared the offering, and he brought a bull and cut it and poured water into that. Then he realized, when he prayed, God came in a form of a light. A light came and hit on the immediately it became fire. When all the things go wrong, God's light is always following you. It will never leave you. When you die, that light will go away from you. Until then, that light will be with you. The problem comes when we don't see that light. We see only ourselves. We see the dark clouds. The moment we see that light, life is built. He knelt down and prayed. In 1 Kings chapter 18, we read this incident. As he started to pray, suddenly a light from the heaven came and hit that offering what he prepared. God is telling, my son, I am always with you. I am with you. That's why in the book of Matthew chapter 28 verse 28, at the last statement Jesus made to the disciples, I am with you all the days of your life. You will never lose even a single minute without my presence, without this light. Your life is full of dark clouds. Sometimes they are frightening clouds. Sometimes disturbing clouds. Sometimes making you cry. Some clouds make you to cry. They will come from the burning things. When the burning dust and dirt comes in the form of dark smoke, it will make your eyes to bring tears. The dark clouds that attack you sometimes make you to be helpless, sometimes make you to even cry. But that is not the end of your life. The little light that I have given to you will always remain with you. Only when you die, it will leave this body and go away. That's why God said in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, verse 7, the mud that is made from this clay, this earth, will go back to mud. But the spirit will return back to God. the human being, without knowing the full truth, they begin to, Satan made them to think, matti nundi vachinadi, matti lone kalavali. I am mud. I will go back to mud. No, the truth is only when the light that God has given to you leaves you, your mud will go to the mud. Until that is with you, your mud cannot. You cut the hand, the breath in you will heal the hand. Only when the breath is gone, this will become rotten. Why? That breath is gone. Only when the breath is gone, until the breath is there, even like any cut, it will fight to heal the wound. The power is in you. The presence is in you. The light is in you. And only when you die, that light will disappear. You will go back. So until that light is in you, let anything happen to this body, let anything happen to this life, that light follows you. The moment we recognize him, that's why the Bible says in Psalm 145 verse 18, the Lord is near to all those who call on him. The Lord is near to all those who call on him in truth. This truth you should realize. What is the truth? Lord is near you. He is with you. He is in you. That's what Jesus said in John's Gospel, chapter 14, verse 15 to 16. The Spirit of God, whom I have given to you, he is with you and he is in you. He is with you and he is in you. Yes, the Lord is near to all those who call on him. And those who call on him with the truth. Many people are calling on God, Lord, I am helpless. Why? They don't know the truth. That God is with them. When something is with you, how can you ask for it? You have the Bible with you, and it is very funny. You say, please give me 5 Bible. When the Spirit of God is with you, and you are saying, please come, come, come. We say, come, 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 because we don't recognize him in us. Call on. So when we know the truth, that sets us free. The enemy is putting us in bondage, in tears. Whenever the children of God in tears, the Lord tells his angels, poor my son, poor my daughter. They don't recognize me in them. They recognize the problem is bigger than me. They think they are broken. And I am there to mend their brokenness. People can break, but they cannot destroy you, because the one who mend is with you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. The what do we call it? The magnet. You try to pull it, it again goes back. You try to take it this far, again it goes back. You take this big, again it goes back. Because the iron gets attracted to the magnet. Yes. And that magnet is God's presence. The more you go far away, again it comes back to you. The more you throw away, but you cannot remove that from you. That is with you. That's why we should know the truth, and the truth is, he is in us.